Right, good morning everyone and welcome to the Jeffersonians. It's a new show and it's going to be a history-based show every Thursday morning. I'm joined by Muhammad, Sophia, Rory, Kelsey and Aaron. How are you guys?
Good, yeah.
Good. Everyone good? Good. Okay, so today we're going to be talking about a very hot topic and a very prevalent one indeed, Syria. We're going to be going over some points for an invasion and against an invasion, but first, let's start with some arguments against an attack. Muhammad.
Well, in my opinion, America should not be the world's policeman, so we should just stay out of it, especially how our economy is doing right now. We really can't afford to go risk ourselves getting into another war.
Okay, that's a very good point. Sophia, you have anything else?
I believe we shouldn't go to it because we don't want to be involved in another civil war just because we came out of Afghanistan and Iran.
Right. Well, I believe we're still in Afghanistan, though.
Okay.
So.
Yeah.
Okay. So it's a financial crisis. It would be detrimental financially. We just can't afford to be in there, considering the bad taste we have in our mouths being in Iraq and Afghanistan. I see that absolutely. But we do have some arguments for. Rory, why don't you fill us in on those?
Well, in my opinion, what Mohammed said earlier about being the world's police, the fact of the matter is that we have actually been a major part of the world's police, and we do have many resources to go to war. As a matter of fact, a lot of, but some Marine Corps companies have actually been disbanded because without a war in the future, there's just no need for them. So they're actually being disbanded and their resources are being put to other uses.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I agree.
Very interesting.
Yeah. Kelsey, what do you say?
Well, in my opinion, that about Syria, over 100,000 people have been killed, and those are real numbers. Whether it's through firearms or chemical weapons, children have died. And that's the sad part about it. The innocent people in the middle of it, not only children, but women and men that have nothing to do with wanting to be in a fight, and they are the ones who are suffering. I believe that it is in our best interest to threaten the Syrian government with an attack. This is important mostly because you don't know what they're going to do in the future. You don't know how it's going to affect us in the future, if they're going to attack us or if they're going to attack our allies. And Obama stated very clearly in his speech the other day that it was very essential for our interests and our safety to carry out an attack.
Right. And I guess you also have to believe those are real numbers. When she says 100,000, numbers like that.
It's always upsetting when you see all the collateral damage when you look back on an attack or war or something like this. All the innocent women and children who died, all the men who lost their lives, not even fighting, just defending their families.
Right, yeah. And like I said, 100,000 is a real number. A lot of times those numbers get fuzzy the bigger they get. But figure it this way. We have about 700 kids in high tech, right? 100,000 divided by 700. That's about 140 high techs. So that's a lot. That's a lot of lives lost.
A lot of people. Right.
Absolutely. And then Aaron, let's see what you have.
Well, I agree with Rory that it's not the it's probably in our best interest to go into their little limited strike just to send a message, tell them that we're serious about if they are going to go against all of our principles, then they should pay for that because it's just a basic violation of everything that everyone in the world stands for.
Absolutely, absolutely, I agree. So what you guys are saying, those who are for going in, our lives are being lost. America traditionally has the responsibility of going in and doing what they can do to prevent more lives from being lost. I see that. Those of you against a Syrian invasion, whether it's a ground attack or some kind of other attack, what is the solution to this problem?
I like what President Obama was stating the other day. I saw a speech that he was giving out. He's not interested in putting American boots in Syria.
Right.
He's interested in doing a military strike. And I'm for that because it's not going to risk any American lives anymore. And it's going to be aimed directly at the Assad regime. Mm. That'll teach him a lesson, you know, and make him think twice about using chemical weapons again.
Right. Certainly, any boots on the ground would be a huge red flag. I'm sure, even if you are for an invasion in Syria, infantry really should not be an option, considering what we had come out of the Iraq war and the war in Afghanistan. Many American lives lost, many Middle Eastern lives lost, and all because of infantry. But you did mention that you think there would be minimal collateral damage if you had a strike that was not infantry.
Mm-hmm.
Some kind of, so what do you think? We could have like a drone strike or something like that, or?
He just said military strike. I'm not sure.
Right.
I'm guessing it would be a drone strike.
Mm. I'm assuming it's like either
maybe an
drones or airstrike.
Well,
or something like that.
If I might intervene real quick, part of Obama showing the muscle to Syria was he sent a large fleet of U.S. Navy ships. In my opinion, what he would do is he would probably have offshore long range missiles attack
That's
the Assad regime.
Another probability.
Right. And would that attack the Assad regime directly?
Well, I mean, it's either you do or you don't.
Right.
So who else are you going to attack but the bad guys?
Well, it's just it becomes a conflict of interest when some of the good guys or some of the innocent people also wreak the havoc of attacking the bad guys. But I see what you mean. But we are here now, and there has not been any military action thus far in Syria. President Vladimir Putin of Russia got involved, and he's acting as the world peacemaker. What do you guys think of that?
Well, we need to get through Russia. We need to find an agreement between Russia and China, since they are the two strongest of allies of Syria. So if we get okay with them, and then Obama's also trying to get okay through the UN.
Right.
To get an attack that way, and it avoids war like that. If you get permission to do it, then
This is Mr. P. I'm just butting in, probably unwarranted, but you know, Russia has to stop sending military arms to Iran if they want to, you know, appear like they're the peacemakers here. So they're a little bit hypocritical far as I'm concerned.
Right.
They have billion-dollar contracts with a lot of Middle Eastern countries, they have no choice. That's how they get.
The whole arms dealing is a lot of the global economy lately.
Yeah.
It's those hundreds of arms deals worth millions of dollars in Russia. And the United States, too, is a big arms dealer in the world. So.
Absolutely. I don't know how many of guys you agree. But I don't know how genuine Russia is in seeing world peace, except for trying to benefit from this somehow. But we'll see. Another thing I wanted to talk about was previous to this deal that Russia had with Syria, President Obama did say that if any chemicals were found, there would be military action. That didn't happen. On an international level, that makes us... it does make us look weaker.
Mm-hmm.
We crossed a line, and we backpedaled very quickly. Do you guys think he's in the wrong for making any claims and before anything happened?
Well, you know, he's got to give a threat,
mm-hmm.
but as of right now, it seems like he is going to take military action eventually. He just needs to get the permission from the UN,
right.
And he's trying to... organize something with Russia.
Mm-hmm. If it's possible to have this end peacefully, I wouldn't see any problem with it, but I don't think that Syria is going to back down, and I don't think that, I think that Russia does have their own agenda in this.
Absolutely.
Even if they if all goes well, nothing will happen.
I know. To be absolutely honest, I wouldn't mind this ending peacefully either. From a political standpoint, looking at Russia acting as the world peacemaker is hysterical. Looking on the outside, and it's hysterical. What they're doing is transparent as can be, but if it works, you know, what the heck, go for it. It's better than losing lives. But hopefully in the long run, it stays like that. I don't think any of us here really want to see more lives lost after Iraq and Afghanistan. We all had a bad taste in our mouths, which... is I think what makes a lot of the American public so wary about going into another war. Well, guys, it's been lovely. It's been fun.
It has indeed.
We got a lot of good points out there, and we will be here next Thursday morning. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in to the Jeffersonians.